Hello, hello, my name is Leo, and welcome to Blau Films. Today we're going to be looking at an example from Operation Deli Platter, and we're going to be discussing how we made the ocean using vector displacement maps. This video will focus on setting up your vector displacement maps inside of Cinema 4D, and then we will look at the shader settings inside of Chaos Corona. Alright, let's get into it. So what is a vector displacement map? I'm sure most of you that work in 3D are familiar with a displacement map, which offsets the vertices or points on a mesh up and down. It contains height information, which is why it's also often called a height map. Now, vector displacement is slightly different because it contains both x, y, and z coordinates, basically being able to displace a mesh into multiple directions. If you've ever worked with ZBrush, for example, you're familiar with VDM brushes. The same can be achieved with a vector displacement map to, for example, create an ocean. You take a plane that has enough poly count, and then you displace it, and here you go, you've got an ocean. I'll make sure to leave a link to this exact texture map that I've been using, so you can use it yourself. Vector displacement maps are usually reserved for offline rendering. I am not entirely familiar with Unreal Engine 5 and what it can do, so if anyone in the comments is using Unreal, do you guys use VDM at all? And if you do, like, leave a comment in the section below. I'd love to learn more about the real-time side of using vector displacement. Now, there are a few cons to this. The first would be technical requirements. You do need somewhat of a rig to not be stuck in incredibly long render times. Just assume you're going to take a little bit more time look deving every time you work with a vector displacement map. So we're inside of Cinema 4D. I'm just going to leave the camera right here. If we move around, we select this layer over here. That's our big cube. And we have a formula effector on it that has a sine wave to it. And that way we can create these ripples that you set behind the boat, kind of like a boat wake. And then we have a linear fall off that is just smoothly fading out the effect. If I check right here, if I select the polygons on my polygon selection tag, you'll see that this middle square has this material, the ocean material. And then I have this other base material that's like a water material that's everywhere. Let me kind of break down that first. It's very simple. We have a dark color, which we're basically not using. Roughness set to about 10%. The further away you are to water, if you just increase the roughness, it will just feel like it's much farther away than that it actually is. But for this distance, about 10 is perfect. We have a IOR of 133 to match whatever it is in water. If we actually take this preview and right-click it, you can change the display mode. So if we put it as a cube, you'll see we have a cube of water. Most of the times with materials like water, it's actually easier to change the display settings to something like a cylinder so that you can compare it with how you know a glass of water would look like. All right, let's go into refraction. We've set that to 100, and then we go to our volumetrics. We have a color over here, and if you see that button is like selected a little bit differently. So we have a bright color that's linked to another materials color. And if we double click the espresso tag that's on the right, this espresso window pops up and you'll see the connection we've made. We've connected the color and we have connected the distance. You just select the layer, then you click this red button over here, and then you go, you select the right setting that you want to match. And then you do the same thing on the blue dial for the other material that you like drag in just like this. You just take a material, you drag it in. If we change one, the other one will change as well. We have a scattering material. We have the noise pattern set to electric. We're making sure that the scale is quite big because we want to make it feel as if a different pockets of water flowing. Except for that, we've just chosen some colors that match the aesthetic of the piece of ocean we're looking for. Water is a really interesting thing. In general, it's just clear, but then you take a whole bunch of water and all those imperfections and the depth scattering all start adding up little by little, and then you add in different water currents, and then you add in different like temperatures, and then before you know, water can almost look like anything you want, really. It's good to just know what basis to build and then what sliders you can change and what tools you can use to get the desired effect. Now let's go into the node material and show you the other one. As you can see, it's basically very simple. We have just added in the displacement channel a vector displacement map. Now we have a max level set to 8, this depends on your scene, and then over here we have a layer. Now the main thing to make this work as a vector displacement map is right here you have to set your texture mode to be vector object. And you have a texture that includes XYZ coordinates, you'll be fine. You'll have suddenly created a vector displacement object. Inside that layer, you'll see I'm just using a transform effect to make sure I can control the angle of the texture map. And that's basically it. And here you go. Applied to an object, you'll see what it kind of does. We have those nice detailed crispy waves in the middle, and then you can really see how dense the volume is we're actually working with. But from the perspective of the camera, for what our purpose is, we get these nice color variations. And if I quickly go through a breakdown of what it looked like first and how it became, you'll see that the first render, we're essentially just using a dark plane with a high reflection and a little bit of a normal map to break it up. And then as we go, I added a little bit of a sculpt. I added just to like block out where we wanted to take it. But once we applied the material I just showed you, suddenly we get this. Suddenly the difference is day and night. You have 3D vector displacement, you have colors, you have depth. Especially if you look at the shadow of the boat, you can see a really nice gradient of values kind of going over and into the water. Now, once we have this setup, it's actually quite easy to just move the camera and create as many renders as you like. That's it for today. Thank you very much for watching. Thank you very much for sticking around. And if you're new here, welcome. Blau Films is an IP development company. We make original projects. We work with the people we like working with. We try to like keep the passion always in the craft of filmmaking. And yeah, we're here to share as much as we know, as much of the assets we develop, we're here to share it with you. We want to see the community grow and collectively everyone learn something from it. So yeah, that's it. That's it for me. Thank you very much. And yeah, bye-bye. Have a good one.